We're continuing with the story in Acts chapter 1 at verse 12 through verse 14. And this is after Jesus has ascended into heaven. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers. Well, this is an interesting snapshot or scene, if you will, of what happens after the ascension of Jesus and before the receiving of the Holy Spirit. The early church is devoting themselves to prayer. Now, when we did our series on the spiritual disciplines, prayer is one of the disciplines that we looked at. It's kind of fundamental to our spiritual toolbox. And we shared how prayer is a believer's communication with God. So it involves God, it involves ourselves, and two-way communication, both speaking and listening. And I picture the prayer that the disciples are devoted to here as much more of listening prayer. It's more in a position of sitting back, wanting to be receptive, waiting faithfully, as Jesus had told them, for the Holy Spirit to come. And you notice it's not just the core of the male disciples, of the apostles, but Jesus' mother Mary is there, as well as other women. So this is a mixed group of the early church. And you also note it says that Jesus' brothers are there. And you recall in an earlier gospel passage where Jesus' mother and brothers and sisters come because people are saying he's out of his mind. But from that early time of their concern for Jesus, through his life, the rest of his life, his death, and his resurrection, clearly his mother and his siblings are now a part of his movement. Of course, we don't hear about his father because we believe that Joseph had passed away sometime before. So, whatever you're facing in your life today, if you have a big decision coming, if there's something you're trying to make a choice about, part of what Acts chapter 1 and these verses tells us is there are times when the best thing we can do is to be quiet, to pray, and to be open to God's voice and the leading of the Holy Spirit. And I invite you to take some time in prayer today, simply to wait upon the Lord.